Okay, so in case the poster didn't make it clear, this is a Japanese anime movie by Hirokazu Ishida. And I don't believe I've seen anything by him before, but yeah, I forgot to look it up. Anyway, the story here follows this young teenage boy, who's a bit of a bookworm, but also scientifically inclined. So when a bunch of penguins suddenly turn up in the middle of the town, he of course sets out to do some research to figure out where they came from and how they got there, which takes him and his friends down a kinda interesting path, which involves a heavy load of increasingly strange fantasy elements. A lot of mysterious events start to take place, and random penguins are just the tip of the iceberg. Oh, and this woman from the dentist's office gets involved and wrapped up in it all too. And yeah, things get weird. This story is actually kinda out there. I mean, it starts off kinda slow, nothing all too crazy going on. But the further into it we get, the more complex and out there things get. And well, it is fantasy, and I don't have anything against all sorts of weird stuff going on. I mean, all the Studio Ghibli movies have a ton of strange stuff in them as well. And this does follow some sort of internal logic that supposedly makes sense within that world. However, I'm not really sure how much sense any of it made to me, personally. Especially toward the very end, the way they wrapped it all up and explained it all. It just felt very wishy-washy and flimsy to me, like they hadn't really thought it through. More like they just made up some stuff on the spot and called it a day. Like they bit off more than they could chew with the whole premise and the whole idea. Then it sort of spiraled out of control and they didn't know what to do with it. So they just did something to bring the story to some sort of conclusion. And I will say, the very, very end I did find to be kinda touching and effective, despite the messy last act. I will also say that the movie as a whole was absolutely beautifully made. And for the most part, I did find it perfectly enjoyable. I definitely didn't hate it. But it didn't really manage to completely grip me at any point either. And therefore, I can't really claim that this is my favorite anime I've seen recently. But I did still think it was well made for the most part, and as a whole, pretty decent. And as I said, it did manage to resonate at certain times too, especially at the very end. I just wasn't completely sold on the story when it comes to the bigger picture. I'm not really sure what the point was or what it was trying to say either. I mean, I guess it's about this teenage boy who's just getting into puberty, and about what a tumultuous and confusing time that can be. But beyond that, if it was trying to make some sort of deeper point or say something more, I certainly missed it, which might very well be an issue on my end. Because I tend to try not to analyze movies too deeply. Mainly because it's all subjective anyway, and you can't really know what the makers really intended. So I feel like it's ultimately kinda pointless, and if the filmmakers want to get a point across, they should probably make it pretty clear and unambiguous. Otherwise, there's a good chance I'm not gonna get it, which might be the case here. You know, maybe I'm just a bit thick and the message is actually very simple and crystal clear. I don't know, but anyway, my rambly point being, I'm not really sure what I'm supposed to take away from this. But it's not a bad movie. It's perfectly watchable. I did enjoy it for the most part. However, would I recommend it? I mean, if you like anime, it might be worth a shot. But if you're usually not a fan of that kind of thing, this probably won't convert you either. So, you know, maybe give it a look. Or don't. After all, I'm not your dad. But hey, what are your thoughts on this? Have you seen it? Did you like it? Let me know. And if you enjoyed the video, maybe give it a thumbs up or sub to the channel, because that would be fantastic. And if you'd like, you can also support me on Patreon or PayPal through the links in the description. And as always, I appreciate you and thanks for watching.